For more videos, visit forthesakeofeducation.com. Alright guys, for this problem they want you to replace a loading system by an equivalent resultant force and coupled moment acting at A. So the first thing I like to do is break down all the forces into X and Y components. This force has a Y component like this and an X component like that. Now let's call this force F, and these forces are straight down, so they both have Y components. So F in the X is equal to 50 times 4 over 5 given in this triangle, and Fy is equal to 50 times 3 over 5, and F in the Y is negative because same in down. So this is 30, negative 30, and this is 40. So now what you want to do is you want to calculate the sum of the moments, sum of the moments in the A. Now you have this 200 newton meter moment given already, so it's 200 newton meter. Let's say clockwise is positive. Let me put the units after so we don't have too much of a mess. 200 newton meters plus the moment created by this force, which is turning this lever arm of length of 3, and it's turning it also clockwise, so it's positive, plus 30 times 3. And then we have this lever arm all the way over here coming down also clockwise by this component right here, which is F of Y, which is 30. This is 30 and this is 40. So 6 times 30. 30 times 6. Now the 40-pound force is not doing any moment because it's aiming straight away from the point. And the force of 40 newtons is aiming straight to the point. So they're not creating no moment. This is the only moment. The moment comes out to be 470. The forces are in newtons and the distances are in meters. For the resultant force, we find the sum of the forces in the X, which we only have one, 40 newtons going to the right, and some other forces in the Y, which is minus 40 is the first one, minus 30 is the second one, minus 30 is the third one, which comes out to be minus 100 newtons. So the resultant force is the sum of this, which comes out to be 40 in the I minus 100 in the J. The magnitude of the resultant force is given by the square root of the X component square plus the Y component square. So when you plug in these two numbers into this formula, you get that the magnitude is equal to 108 newtons. And the angle, remember, 40 to the right, 100 down. So this angle right here, let's call it theta of F of R, is going to be equal to the tangent inverse of the opposite over the adjacent, which is 40. And it comes out to be 68.2 degrees. I'll put negative because it's coming down. If this would be the x-axis, it's 68.2 coming down. So this is the angle, magnitude of the resultant force, and moment created at A. Final answers.
Please comment below if you want me to do any problems, and I'll be happy to help. Thank you.